Welcome to Somethin Crunchy. Tyler is homies with Blake. Blake is the older bro of Blair. Blair is married to Tyler and is a slutty slut slut.
Welcome to Somethin Crunchy.
What the hell is crunchy?
Welcome to Somethin Crunchy.
All right, back in the studio with my brother Tyler, and here's our other co-host, Tyler's wife. Let's put him up. How are we feeling tonight?
Blank. Oh my God, man. I'm 100% high, 50% drunk, and 3,000% fucking stoked to be back.
That's right.
We're back.
Welcome to season three of Somethin Crunchy. It's good to be back. Blair, you've lost weight.
I have, thank God. It was a wonderful break. Had a sweet baby boy, but ready to be back and drinking with the boys.
That's right. We are glad to have Blair back. She hasn't had a drink in like 6 weeks, so she's coming back
the
with
old
a vengeance.
Sober season two.
6 weeks. She took 9 months off, everybody.
Our first episode, when we returned last season, it was St. Patty's Day. And Biscuits and I got pretty toasted doing what we branded the Chumbawamba Challenge.
Uh-huh. I remember, barely.
Which, to be honest, wasn't that much of a challenge. We get pretty Patrick's wasted around
here.
I'm
pretty proud of y'all.
Yeah. But for Blister, who drinks like a neck of beer on a good night, it should be a challenge. Good luck be.
Good luck.
I am terrified for this,
season
by the
three,
way.
Chumbawamba Challenge.
I'm in no way in shape or prepared for this.
So you've like already almost knocked out your lager drink and you're about to move on to your whiskey drink.
Yes, and I'm already feeling quite warm inside.
Pretty whiskied.
So whiskied right now. I took like three sips of it, and I'm like, and I'm whiskey drunk.
So we made some moves over break, gained a couple strong affiliates, which means we make a little money doing the show. You save a little money listening to the show. Thank you, Invicta Watches and 8080. Discount code Crunchy for both. What's up?
Heyo.
We created a Facebook group over break, where you can interact with us and find an endless supply of the web's crunchiest memes. We're having a good time in there.
We are having a good time in there. It's hilarious.
Be prepared for what you might see.
Yeah, it's fucking funny, y'all.
It's funny.
It's funny.
We've also added another member to the Crunch team. He's behind the scenes, but we are excited for the show to have a little representation. Thank you, Steve.
Yes.
Steve.
In addition to new segments, more games, and big things in the haps for season three, we're also adding music to the mix, showcasing some of the best tracks from up-and-coming artists, and we are doing it every week. That is what's
exciting.
Up.
That's exciting. I can't wait.
That is neat. Pump for that.
Some stuff you haven't heard before.
Good original music.
For our returning listeners, we are so glad you came back to Crunch Down with us.
Yes.
And we know that we have some new listeners joining us this season. And if it's your first time listening to Somethin Crunchy, you have to fight. Biscuits. Let's talk about your break, brother.
Oh, you know, same old, same old. Had a baby.
Had a baby.
Played in a terrible golf tournament. You know, samesies.
Ready to crunch. Right.
So fucking ready to crunch.
Missed yeah. it.
My break sucked.
Oh, what happened?
Your break sucked?
Other than like what we got done around here, and we got a lot accomplished. I mean, for my break, other than, you know, getting a new nephew, let's see, I got some dental work done.
Oh, fun.
Shopped for a new car warranty.
No.
And struggling for a reason to live.
Yeah.
It's still pretty 2020 out there, but I did go out for a beer and meet a friend.
You made a friend.
That was very exciting. Wait. Like actually going out. It was like a...
Like a date?
It was like a restaurant that had a beer. No, I went and met up with a buddy, but actually it kind of led into almost a date, but he fucked that up.
It was just a fine
example of how we are not ready to be reintroduced back into the wild.
Yeah.
Our social skills have taken a huge hit with this quarantine. We were single and forgot how to mingle, and at least he did.
What happened? He freeze?
It's worse.
Cause... Oh my God. He and I sat down with a couple ladies for a drink, and they both get these huge novelty margaritas with all kinds of pineapple and shit hanging off
of
it.
So they're like ready for a good time.
We're talking about who gives a rip. And at one point, one of these girls holding up a piece of pineapple asks, is it really true what they say about pineapple and guys?
She did not.
Of course, before she could even finish the question, I'm already nodding like a bobblehead, like totally. But my kamikaze pilot of a wingman volunteers the response. No, I looked that up. It's actually just a myth. Doesn't really work. I look at him like,
What are you doing?
Are you serious? No, 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 ladies. Like, he's just kidding. And it also takes 7 years to digest. This girl inquires about a pina colada, and you basically just said, no, I don't very much care for blowjobs. Thank you. We all fucking know it's a bullshit, completely made up myth, but they don't, man. Hit the bench, 22.
Come on.
God. Sums up my break.
My God.
What are you doing?
Totally blew it.
The tone is back that way.
I feel like we should be talking about, you know, the shit we saw over break and get caught up on our recs and reviews. Like, that would be in our style. But that would just be a huge waste of Drunk Blair. and we don't want to be wasteful.
Doesn't quite go hand in hand with the Chumbawamba Challenge.
Yeah, we're here to hear her say moist more than anything else.
Oh, my God.
Don't start with that. Too early for that.
I'm not drunk enough for that.
So... reboots are the big thing right now.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There's so many fucking reboots out. It's become a segment on our show because we have to cover all the fucking reboots that are getting the boot. I mean, Doogie Howser is being booted now, for crying out loud.
Oh, really?
With the female player. Really? Uh-huh. Ooh, you don't
good.
Say. Oh. Doogie?
I like a good boot sometimes, okay?
Hold the phone.
I mean, of all the boots to get excited about, I mean...
Don't hate on that boot.
A Doogie with no MPH, that's...
Oh, there's no MPH?
No.
It's a female
then
doctor.
It's a female... It's not even, like, the real Doogie. It's like, if you told me, like, MPH comes back to play Doogie, I'd be like, yeah, that's what's up.
Yeah.
Where's he been?
I thought it was, like, going to be with him being older and, like, his life now.
No. I don't know. That could go either way. Lots of boots.
Yes.
They're not making the right ones.
What would you want to say?
Tiny boots.
I want to talk about, like, one that would be so easy to reboot. There's one that I would be excited to see rebooted. It's just this, it's the lowest hanging fruit MTV is just not thinking about.
What are you thinking?
Celebrity Deathmatch.
Fuck yeah.
Yes.
Remember some Celebrity Deathmatch?
Yeah. Claymation?
Claymation.
Yeah.
You don't have
to do that.
It's the one you don't have to bring back the original cast and worry about all that because it's always up to date and culturally relevant.
Yeah.
It's exciting.
It's exciting. It's appropriate.
Ooh, I like
it's
that.
Exciting.
So I'll tell you what.
Huh.
They're not using Celebrity Deathmatch. Probably not safe for us to call it that. So we'll do a Celebrity Death Punch or Famous People Death Fight. All right. Celebrity Kill Match. That's what we'll call it.
Oh, like yeah.
Celebrity Kill Match.
Famous Fights.
Let's bring this shit back.
Oh, yeah. I'm into it.
And if they like see a problem with it, bring it back yourself, and we won't have to do this for you.
Hang on, I got notes. Let me write some notes down.
You need to think. It's all about the matchup, and obviously the three of us. So two out of three is going to determine the winner of the fight.
I'm trying to think of.
You better take notes, B. Hurry up.
Okay, let me give you a fine example of what I'm talking about and how I would like to see a modern celebrity deathmatch start.
Let's get an example here.
I'm thinking like. I want to start with Jonah Hill, but you can't just say Jonah Hill. You have to specify where from. So I would say
that's true because
there's a lot of fluctuation in Jonah Hill.
He's made some transformations.
And it's the actor, not the character. But I'm saying Jonah Hill, Moneyball Jonah
Hill. Okay.
Against Rosie O'Donnell, 1990s, like League of Their Own, Rosie O'Donnell. Celebrity kill match, celebrity kill fight.
That's a fight.
Who's going to win?
Moneyball Jonah Hill.
Athletic Rosie.
Athletic Rosie.
Versus unathletic Jonah.
But that's a solid foundation for some man right there.
It certainly makes you think.
And he's smart. Keep in mind, that doesn't help you much in a fight against like a raging...
Statistically, he knows which punch is going to land, but can he throw it?
I think Rosie's got a little bit more oomph behind her. Like, I bet she'd get scrappy in that fight.
Would she play third? Yeah, she's going to win.
Would she play third?
All right.
Like, so that's what determines.
1990 Rosie was definitely going to be in better shape than Moneyball Jonah Hill.
Right.
So 100%. I'm thinking if Jonah can't...
And she's got, like, fight in her. She's got some, like...
If he can't handle it in the early rounds... Or like in the early first round, even
knock her, if he doesn't knock her out in the first punch, he's
gonna
fucked.
Lose.
He's gonna lose. He's got one shot. You got 100% in that first punch, and after that, you're fucked.
Well, I hate to say it, this seems like it's going unanimously towards 1990 Rosie O'Donnell in this first match.
Wow, this is gonna be interesting.
Didn't see that coming.
I'd take any year Rosie O'Donnell versus any year Jonah Hill. Honestly.
Blair, did that give you any ideas as to like a solid Celebrity death punch?
Man. Okay, now this has really got me thinking. Now that you went that route, like, I'm flipping everything around.
You're flipping the script already?
You were going one way, but now you're going somewhere
else. Yeah, because now I'm going to get, like, a little weird on it. I'm thinking Jodie Sweetin.
Mm-hmm.
But right. I, like, just thinking about who she would Full be House? A good matchup. No, now. Now Jodie versus Justin Bieber.
Okay. That's a good one.
Wait, no, it's not. Jodie Sweetin versus yes. Justin Bieber.
Yes, both now.
Well, the Biebs.
No.
100% Biebs.
Really?
He's like a, he's been training as a boxer for a long time because people have been picking on his ass, so.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
Jodie could be training.
She could be, but I know Bieber is 100% trained.
Well, what if Jodie had just like a little bit of, like in a little line before the match. Like just like a little, just like right before the match.
She could take two shots from Justin, but I think he knocks her out.
Just to give her just like a little bit more. All right.
So and like a working out Bieber against just like a little Sweden. Like.
Maybe this would be Jodie just like back a little, in her.
A couple of bumps.
Maybe both of them in their crazy phase.
100% mm. Justin.
Yeah, realistically. It's going to have to be the Biebs.
I'm Team Jodie.
But I like Blair's.
I'm sticking with
Jodie. She would need a lot of to make it competitive, I think.
You think?
I don't know. She's kind of got the size on him, though, doesn't she? Like the height? Like, and she's.
She's scrappy.
She could be scrappy.
I bet she.
And she could be.
She could take
strength.
A punch.
I don't right. know.
Four or five.
It's kind of a weak fight. I like where that's going to go.
Some would be more surprising than anything. I'm going Team Jodie.
I'm on the fence. It's all about. Blair's edition, which made like
it changes
a huge
everything.
Difference. Yeah. Biscuits, what you got?
How do you feel about like a fatal four-way?
Love it already.
Oh my God.
Dwayne, the 9-inch Rock Johnson, and Jason Statham.
Ooh.
Oh,
versus Terry Crews.
Oh, yes.
And Ice Cube.
Ooh.
Wow. Oh, I like what you're doing there.
I don't know.
Now, that's a fight.
That.
That's what I came up with.
Holy crap. Okay. So, like,
you, I thought Dwayne
you got
was
kind of a Fast and Furious universe
anybody.
Against the Friday.
It's the Friday.
It's the Friday, Friday universe.
Is yeah. like one of the only people I can see putting up a real fight against Dwayne.
You got
Johnson.
Two ex football players just going at it. The real fight is between Ice Cube and Jason Statham. Is Statham.
He's smaller than Cube, right?
He's tiny, but is he movie ready or is he like actually ready to
Statham,
fucking throw down?
If you've learned from earlier episodes. Of Somethin Crunchy was a diver before he was famous.
Like, how does that
like
help him in
a
fight?
A high diver.
He was a competitive
That's my point exactly.
faller.
He was into a sidewinder. Yeah, he's a triple twist into a sploosh and hope you get the tiniest little splash.
Well, he's going to do it
like he's from a very privileged delicately. Upbringing. An Ice Cube.
Cube's from the streets.
Compton.
Yeah.
Like Cube is like West Coast hood like. Gangster
I was already
rap, like the birth
thinking,
of gangster
I
rap.
Was already on Terry Crews' side, so now that you said that, like, that's my pick. Cube and Crews.
Cube would crush Statham. Do you disagree,
I'm going
Tyler?
Cube and Crews.
No, if we're going to break it down to just basically a one-on-one fight and the other two is a draw, yeah, I think Cube fucks Statham up so bad. Sold.
And Cube.
Pay-per-view. Sold.
Cubed. Okay. Going a different direction here.
Okay.
How do we feel about Billie Eilish
yes.
versus Ozzy Osbourne?
Ozzy Osbourne? Now? 2020 Ozzy Osbourne.
Yeah.
Versus Billie Eilish.
No.
He is the Prince of Darkness.
He'd probably like bite her finger off.
Exactly. And who knows what she could get from that. Like.
And I don't think she's got the fight in her.
No, you seem to think Billie had
Ozzy
this wrapped
might be
up
a little
right
bit
away.
Older now, but.
Yeah, Billie's got this wrapped up.
Really?
No problem. Yeah, in his prime,
no,
he could
get dirty
her
in
up.
That fight.
Mm-mm. I think she'd get killed.
Yeah, I'm so with you on
not
that.
No way, not a chance.
Real. Yes.
No, fuck no, because. What is he going to do? Cast a spell on her? Like, he's like, hi, come here. to me.
No, he's going to go in, rip a couple, like, bite a couple fingers off, start
he
there.
Can't do that anymore. He doesn't even have his own teeth.
She's too young. She's got him.
She's got him with stamina.
She's too strange.
I bet he'd get dirty and creative on it.
Like Sweden would need a surprise, Ozzy would need a miracle here in this fight.
Yeah, he needs some magic.
Think Billy's
if,
too
if we're being realistic here, like if we were going to go realistic with
I don't think
Bieber
she's crazy
beating
enough
Sweden.
For Ozzy.
Really?
If he still has his like wild crazy, if he's like gotten soft over the years and
his
like,
mind.
Sidebar. Ozzy fans versus Billie Eilish fans.
No comparison.
Oh, Aussie fans.
Aussie fans.
The Aussie fans are going to take
down. Billie Eilish fans are like 13-year-old girls that like cry in their bedroom.
In numbers, though. They've got like.
So more 13-year-old girls against Ozfest. Like Ozfest.
Maybe people go to Ozfest every year.
Let's show side-by-side of pictures of those concerts. And y'all tell us what you think is the winner of that fight, the fans.
Okay, you win.
All right, I'm going to go a different route here. I'm going to go like 90s kind of throwback. What about like a Devin Sawa, Shia LaBeouf fight?
Ooh, that's a fight.
Couple of crazies. I like that.
That's a fight.
You think that'd be crazy?
Well, I mean, Shia's certifiably crazy. No, but Devin is. He's a fighter.
Oh.
Devin's like fighting now. That's like what he does.
Okay, what are their heights, you think?
Devin
Sawa's
taller. I bet Devin's
taller.
Got him like by an inch or two.
I'm going to say 3+ experience in full contact sports and fighting. So,
but Shia's got like a black belt in bar fights.
And like a little crazy when he wants to be, which is crucial for celebrity.
But he's gotten the control of his crazy.
Yeah, but you can unleash that power whenever you want to.
It's
if
true.
You're in celebrity deathmatch and it's like, this is where you unleash your crazy.
But where that it's matters is the first 4 shots. So I think... I definitely think Shia could take 4 shots from Devin and wake up and start to fight, but Devin's going to be dodging punches because it's what he's been doing for the last 10 years instead of acting is fighting. Like
that's
right. It's all he does is fight.
Yeah. Well,
and that's a different world when you got an amateur versus a professional.
Player? I didn't know that.
Yeah. Oh yeah, Devin's a full-time fighter.
Well, I'm a Devin Sawa.
So you were like,
I was going to go Devin anyway.
He could keep
so this
you
is really,
either way.
It wouldn't matter. He could have like never fought a day in his life and just been a little sweepy and I'd be like, I'll take Devin.
I love him anyway.
Look how cute he is. I'll pick Devin.
What do you guys think about like a funny fight, like Hannibal Buress versus Jason Segel?
Thank you. That's like,
ooh, that's a fun fight.
That's interesting.
Wait, who's going to win that fight?
Now that's interesting.
Okay, so I feel like Jason's a little bit taller.
He's like 6'5". He's huge.
He's got some stretch.
But Hannibal's
got, bigger.
I feel like Hannibal's hands are bigger.
Yeah.
I don't know why.
You like
but
think his
so,
fist would like be make a bigger
he's
impact
so
to
slow.
Your face.
He's such a slow talker.
He's kind of a sloth.
He's kind of sloth. And he's gonna.
You think it'd be the
keep
same
that smile
to his
when he gives
fighting?
You the punchline?
He fights like with just like a little bit of hesitation, like just like the same way that he talks.
That's kind of what I'm seeing. Not that Jason Segel's like this
any faster.
He's
the same way.
Kind of, but he's.
He's a little soft.
He's lanky.
He's a little soft. Do you think he's like beef enough to?
I don't know.
He played.
It might be a slower fight overall, but it'd be interesting to see in the end.
It's
like he'd pull it out.
Watch Shaq fight Rasheed Wallace. Like it's a bunch of really, really, really big guys.
But you know it's going to be just like the slowest.
And you're waiting for the knockout, but they just hit nothing but air for about 10 minutes.
I want to go Jason for the reach, but. I just realistically don't see that happening.
But Burris have more stamina, I bet, so it would like last longer.
I bet you neither one of them connect.
It would just be a bunch of misses.
Yeah, and then they tucker out.
I definitely think yes. And then they
draw.
Just fall.
And then Hannibal would beat him with his indifference.
I think that's exactly how it go, actually. I think we pretty much called that.
All right, cool. Yeah, I'm not buying that on pay-per-view. I just thought it'd be funny to watch for a sec.
I want to see Frances McDormand fight.
Oh, I'm all about that.
I just want to see her fight. And
oh,
the only
so
person I
that.
Could think of
Hi.
To see her fight
Who?
Is Christoph Waltz. I see that.
Talking about a sloth
what?
Fight.
No way.
Frances all day.
I miss you and I love you. She would fuck.
You don't up. Fuck with Francis.
You think she would fuck him up?
Yes.
Christoph Waltz.
I'm.
Christoph Waltz, he can, when talking to you, like feels like it's like he's gonna kill me in a different way.
He is a very good actor, and I think he could act badass with Tarantino behind
him.
I think, but in real life, she's badass off camera,
and 100%. She needs
Tarantino
smart.
To look badass,
and he's quite small.
He is quite small.
She's got more fire.
I bet you she has a 6-inch height advantage and a 9-inch reach on Christoph Waltz.
Not that much.
Guaranteed.
Really?
He's not that much, but I'm still going fellow. Francis all day. My girl, love her. She's going to win.
Wow. So this is unanimous for Francis?
Yeah. Unanimous for Francis.
Interesting outcome.
Hashtag unanimous for Francis. Who else is unanimous for Francis?
Oh, that's a good one.
These are some good matchups, y'all.
So far, so good.
So far, yeah.
All right, well.
What are you thinking about?
You brought up another one? Well, you brought up like the tag team situation, so that kind of like made me think.
Okay.
How do we feel about like a Pauly Shore and Andy Dick?
Okay.
Versus right. like Ryan Seacrest and Andy Cohen?
Oh.
Lots of slaps.
It's a slap fight, that's but I love fight. It, buddy.
I bet it gets like scrappier than we think. Like surprise scrap, like.
Andy Dick is just going to come out and...
Next on Celebrity Slap Fight.
Celebrity Slap Match.
Ooh.
Pauly's definitely slapping around in there.
This is as much as I want and would root for Pauly and Andy. And I mean, I really would.
Andy Cohen and Ryan Seacrest, I think, are going to take
those are some like drugged out guys that like their bodies are hurting.
Yeah, they couldn't last longer their bodies, than 10 seconds.
Their bodies... are showing signs of wear and tear.
Deterioration.
And
sure.
Ryan Seacrest and Andy Cohen.
They are
like,
on point.
They are like TV ready,
yeah.
fit.
Yeah.
Fit,
like,
yes.
You're not going to find a lot more fit guys and like ready to go.
No,
I totally agree.
12 packs of abs between the two of them.
See, yeah. and I think Pauly and Andy might need a little to get through this one.
They
too.
Would need it to live through it, I think.
Especially for recovery.
Yeah.
Why do I see Andy Dick definitely having like not a lot of clothes on during this fight? Like I immediately just see him like in
that's
a
all he's got. Distraction. He's
something.
Trying to distract.
Get on his cheeks.
I know. Why am I just immediately going there?
But they were both in the army now.
Mm-hmm.
Is that
no?
No.
No. And it's not as if like that was their. Tough gladiator roles, the,
yeah.
Like the Christoph Waltz example we
the
had.
Desert.
Like they were out armied by Lori Petty.
That's true.
So we're unanimous on the Ooh, Ryan
Pauly Seacrest Shore and Andy Dick versus Lori Petty.
Now that is a much better fight.
Petty,
what do you think?
It's a lot more even now.
Tank Girl,
I want to go. I want to go with the boys. I want to go for the boys on this one.
I
Furta.
Think that would be a long...
Let's go Furta, buddy.
That'd be a
Furta.
Long fight. I think it'd be a good one, but no. I bet Lori Petty would take him. I bet
Lori
she'd
Petty,
do it like fast and just come in like...
She would hit both of them like square
smart,
in the nose one time.
Knows where to hit them, right. Do
and
it
then
right.
that would be it. They'd yeah. both be like, ah.
They would take one hit each and be done.
Yeah,
and she would know exactly it. Where to hit them and how. I'm going Lori.
That's interesting.
She would take like, you know, the crazy
she
route.
She has training. She knows what's up.
Speaking of crazy, what do you think about Nick Nolte versus Gary Busey?
Oh, my God.
I used to get these two mistaken all the time, but
that's
who
fantastic.
Would win in a fight?
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's
see,
a
I,
great match.
Part of me wants to immediately go Nick Nolte. But
me
then,
too.
But
me
then
too.
I think Busey and, like, again, crazy goes a long way.
The higher the crazy factor, the less the pain scale. Like,
exactly.
they don't understand
That's
pain
such a
good anymore.
Point. Excellent, excellent point.
You got to have, like, just a little bit to, like, really.
There's no way I'm not going Nick Nolte on this. I don't care about Rabbit Punch, Sidewinder, Gary Busey.
Like,
no way.
Blue chips, Nick Nolte could fuck him up or what?
Even just, if that guy is, even just 20% of him exists in modern day Nick Nolte, I'm betting on that guy. That is frightening.
I like Gary in this one. I think you could just like...
Really?
I think Gary might have it.
You guys are outside of your mind.
Gary's like one of those villains that you can shoot him 12 times in the face and he just keeps coming at you because
exactly.
He's like...
Exactly. You punch him a million times and he's like standing there just like giving
he's
you
a bag
face.
Of mush and he keeps coming.
So you're
coming.
Not betting that like against Nick Nolte winning. You're betting that Gary Busey just can't be beaten.
I bet Nick is gassed because after his one good punch
he's immortal.
Face, and Busey just stands there and takes all the punches. I don't even know if Busey throws a punch throughout the whole thing.
He just sits there and
philosophizes with him.
He waits for Nick
he just,
to tuck
like,
her out.
The faces and just, yeah.
Nick's just like, I'm done. I can't lift my arms anymore.
Yeah.
Gary's like, I win, you bitch.
He
fucked
didn't have
up.
To even like throw a punch. Nick just gasses out completely.
That's a good place to take a break. We'll stop right here. We'll be back with some more Celebrity
so
Death
good.
Punch in just a moment.
Hey guys, thanks for listening to Somethin Crunchy, and I hope you're enjoying the episode. It now pays to crunch down every week because we're hooking you up with big discounts from big brands. Up to 35% off Invicta watches using code CRUNCHY and apparel from 8080. Where in addition to 10% off using code CRUNCHY, every dollar you spend goes toward an entry into the Dream Car giveaway. Don't forget to join the Somethin Crunchy Facebook group for updates, polls, and the web's crunchiest memes. You can find us on Twitter at crunch_cast. And feel free to send any questions and your track submissions to somethincrunchy@gmail.com. Now, let's get back to the show.
And we're back.
Yes.
It's good to be back.
Feels right.
This is good.
Yeah, I like it.
And I'm not going to lie, I came up with a couple more.
I've been taking notes.
I came up with a couple over break. I'm pumped to get back into it. I got a fight.
What you got?
I got a fight. And I like specifying like
which fight
like
it
what,
would be.
What year what, or like
exactly.
What size are you referring to?
I'm thinking Chevy Chase, 1984. Against
84.
Like Fletch Chase?
Yes. Like, just a year or two after Caddyshack.
Okay.
Against Jim Carrey, 94.
6'4", big teeth, kind of giggling.
Chevy. Now, Chevy is the perfect amount of asshole to win a fight.
Yeah.
I'm going to say Chevy all day.
He has got the off-camera asshole factor to totally win a fight.
And size.
In 84, he is in his prime. And he's got some size, he's got some reach. But there's no way I'm betting against Jim Carrey.
You think?
Jim Carrey has got that...
I've got one
physical
argument.
Comedy. That was the, like...
That is true. He
that
would
was
throw
the time
like,
for
the
physical
place.
Comedy, and you can't do that unless you have stamina power. He is a freak of nature. And, of course, he has that nice dose of inner narcissistic rage.
Yeah, I got one
argument
against that one right there.
What you got?
He's Canadian. Jim Carrey's Canadian. He can't punch anybody. He's too nice.
That's so not true.
Sweet.
So not true.
He's 100% Canadian.
It's a horrible stereotype. It really is. The Canadian stereotype that they can't fight. I don't approve of that.
Yeah.
I think it'd be a good fight. But
George St. Pierre is also Canadian.
I am here to make fun of Canadians for so many things. I can make a list.
But not their fighting.
We will have a segment for making fun of Canadians soon. But they could fight.
There's a couple that
hockey
can fight. But
fighters.
That is so true. They have like they will knock your face apart and their own. Like
think of those D-gens from Upcountry when you're watching Letterkenny next time. Tell me you can't see some fights going on.
Ooh.
They're too nice. Still in my book.
I still think Chevy's got this one just because.
And you too.
Yeah.
You're putting Chevy Chase is winning this fight?
Yeah.
I think Jim Carrey would last longer, but I think Chevy's got the power.
Y'all have
for patriotic
really, really
reasons,
disappointed me.
I'm betting on Chevy.
For patriotic reasons. That's your argument. Okay, so I feel like I kind of want to see Angelina Jolie fight.
I mean, I'd watch her fight anything.
I'd like to see like, some,
I know that y'all,
some Mrs. Smith.
Y'all could definitely see that.
I'd watch her.
Many what? People fighting her. Would you see her fight Charlize Theron?
Ooh.
Ooh, that's a good fight.
That's a good fight.
Like, they're
the atomic blonde against the atomic bitch.
One of them is South African. One of them thinks that she's South African.
Oh, that's great.
I don't know. I think Charlize has this.
Atomic B against Tomb Raider. I'm going the Atomic Blonde.
Really?
Yeah.
Charlize has got
Charlize.
This is now and not, or just in their prime? Or
I think it's at any time. Because they've both kind of followed the same. I'm leaning towards Angelina.
I mean, Charlize does smoke a lot of weed. She might be like sleepy for the fight.
Mr. and Mrs. Smith?
Again, no. acting for those roles.
It's very different that we are talking about the actors themselves.
I agree.
But you do have to be in shape to do those.
You have to be skinny to do that. You don't have to be in shape.
There's a difference.
I disagree. I disagree. You go make 3 Tomb Raider movies and tell me you're not in more shape.
The Tomb Raider diet.
I'm on the Tomb Raider diet.
We call this one the Raider diet.
That is a really good one. I'm kind of torn.
You're torn. I call Charlize. What if Winner fights Uma Thurman?
That is really good.
Oh my god, right?
Oh
yeah.
I can see that happening. That is really good.
That's an interesting fight.
Things up.
So, Mexican standoff.
Yes.
The three-way Mexican standoff?
Mexican standoff is a three-way.
I guess I don't have to say the three-way. Part of that.
I think Uma, with that Kill Bill experience, if we're going to talk about...
Plus, she doesn't care if she gets hit in the face.
What? Did you make that up, or is this like known fact?
Uma's gonna be tough to beat, but
I think Uma versus Charlize.
These are all evenly matched.
Fight.
Uma against Charlize would be a good fight. And in that fight, I'm going Uma. I think that she would win, and I think that she would do it with class, grace, and elegance.
She's got training. She could do it with like one punch, like straight to the fit. Like she's been training like she did in like the...
One throat punch.
Yes.
For sure.
And you're down.
And out.
Do you remember her training from Pai Mei?
Hey, I'm sure it was somewhat real.
That's what I came up with real fast. What about a Karate Kid fight? Ralph Macchio versus Hilary Swank.
Now
that's a fight.
Love this fight.
Okay.
Oh, Swank.
Now, Ralph was the only one to actually get the tutelage of Mr. Miyagi. Now, that's got to account for something, seeing he was the most powerful force in the Karate Kid universe. However, Swank, like, would kick the shit out of Ralph Macchio if Karate
Swank,
Kid had nothing
Swank
to do with it.
Swank gets stronger, like, every year, so it's like...
Million Dollar Baby Swank. What was the new one we saw? The adult Hunger Games?
Oh, yes.
Kill Island, The Kill.
The Kill
The Kill.
Island.
The Kill.
That's
the Kill?
Not it.
I think it's called The Kill.
That's not.
Look it up.
We'll fact check that.
Yeah.
It's not.
I think we're headed with this.
I'm thinking Swank.
It's Swank. I think, again, back in the day or today, it's...
Well, what are your thoughts on it?
Seriously, Swank.
100% Swank.
This is just unanimous, not even close?
Well, this is like... backyard brawl, right?
Yeah.
We're not fighting for points here, because Macchio might get you on the points in a technicality.
I see what you're saying.
Because that kick to the face with the karate...
So
with
you're
the
saying,
kick
you're saying in,
illegal,
in an organized
Hillary
karate fight,
could...
you could see Macchio putting up a fight, but
yeah,
in a backyard
clean.
Brawl.
She could fight clean.
It's Swank.
She knows the rules. She's smart.
Well, I think
smart,
we got, I think
strong,
we got,
Swank.
I think we got a unanimous Soul. Swank here. How do we feel about like a Daniel Stern against Bob Saget?
Oh, I love this.
Got some tall
See,
guys
part
from
of
the
me
90s.
Wants to go. Ooh, I don't think Saget could have it in him.
It's just a narrator fight. Who could fight better with the narration with the voiceovers?
It is like the voiceover battle.
Daniel Stern.
We just like Stern so much more.
I think he's more athletic.
What on earth makes you say that?
He's been in sports
what
movies.
What on earth would make you say that?
I think he likes football.
Football fan definitely makes you a fighter.
John Wayne fan.
John Wayne.
I don't know.
Okay. I'm trying to fight you on this, which sounds like I'm defending Bob Saget, but in my head, I'm still thinking
Bob Saget's more athletic?
No.
Exactly.
I think he's more coked up, so that might have something to do with it. I feel like he could take another extra 4 or 5.
See, if he had a
that's true.
Dozen shots to the head and not feel it.
I bet he'd feel it.
And he's got such an ego.
In his head,
he'd be like, oh, I'm totally going to win. He would tell everybody that he's going to win and then just like knock out.
Stern would pound him.
I think
half
Stern
a six
would
pack and
pound his ass.
Get two good shots in. That's all he need. Have you seen Stern's beard recently? That beard is heaping handfuls of, I don't want to fuck with that.
He's got
like,
it.
Like, I wouldn't fuck with you.
He's got it.
Catch something
with
that
or
beard.
Without beard.
Yeah, man. What you got, B?
All right. Well, I think I want to go Anna Kendrick. I want to kind of see her in a fight.
Okay.
But I'm kind of seeing Nick Kroll fighting her.
That's a good fight.
What do you think about that?
That's a good fight.
What?
Anna Kendrick against Nick Kroll.
Makes you think.
Man, I want Nick to win this fight.
I want him to. I don't think he's gonna.
He's got to win this.
I don't know.
Anna's...
She's small, but she's scrappy.
5'0". She's not even scrappy.
She's probably like 90
She's not
pounds.
Scrappy.
Just about to say that. 5'0", 100
Yeah. She's younger and in better shape and quicker, and that's all she's got. But her blows will have no power.
Nothing. Nothing behind it.
Not that Nick is in particularly good shape. I'm not saying Nick is in prime position to win this bout.
What kind of shape is he in right now?
But I'm saying kind of like the last fight, all he has to do is just connect a couple.
So you're saying it's a slap fight?
I'm saying she has got those little tiny chicken legs. All he has to do is give her one little kick to the shin. She's tipped over.
Yeah.
And it's a fight. Celebrity death punch.
Celebrity leg kick.
Yeah.
You know, one time she's down.
Yeah, for sure.
Celebrity she can leg just sweep. As easily leg sweep him.
She might sweep the leg for a point, but
she has no no legs to sweep with. Like she can't. The same thing with the punches. Just no power behind them. I'm going Nick Kroll he sneaks by, like just a squeaker, in a squeaker.
In a judge's decision.
Yeah. I love it.
Still be fun to watch.
What do you think about Superwoman Gal Gadot versus Michelle Rodriguez?
No, that's
yes.
a fight.
Like a true badass yes. versus a screen badass.
This has got pay-per-view written all over it.
Yeah.
People would definitely pay to see that. It'd be hot.
People would pay a lot of money to see Michelle Rodriguez kick the shit out of Gal Gadot.
I was about to say the exact opposite.
Really?
I bet Gal.
That's what I was hoping for.
This one.
Gal Gadot.
Michelle
is so
would
hot.
Be the only.
She was military, wasn't she? Wasn't Gal like
Gal, yes.
Israeli military?
Oh,
like,
yeah. She knows what's up.
We learned all kinds of stuff from previous episodes. You did that on here too before
they
were
famous. She 100% has the in real life experience to just like. She would come over, jump, and like crack her neck, and
have you seen
just like one punch, dead?
But those abs,
Michelle would look cute, but she would definitely
no. You don't get
and put
you don't
up
get,
a fight.
You don't accidentally fall into some abs like that.
No.
That's a regiment.
No, and she is athletic, and I think that she could put up a fight. But I think Gal just has like again like military experience
and the reach advantage.
And
so
she's
you,
a little bit
so
bigger.
You guys have Gal Gadot winning this.
Bigger
yes.
titties,
you know,
like that's got to mean something.
Michelle's titties.
You guys are you guys are so married right now. let's go athletes. Let's get something to like. We can really get some some athletes involved. I want to talk about LeBron James fighting the Williams sisters.
Oh,
both of them,
Venus and Serena Williams.
Oh, I'm sticking with the girls.
You're thinking those four thighs can take down
those
the king?
Legs would take him down.
Really?
Yeah.
They've got power. They've got strength. They've got fight.
They he got is style, a 6 foot eight man.
They got it all. He's big, but them, both of them together, done. Powerhouse duo.
What do you think? What do you have to say about this?
In a fight?
I think it'd be hard because he's huge and would definitely put up a fight.
If you give him rackets, they have a chance.
If it's a tennis match.
They don't need rackets.
No. If they can fight with their rackets, they have a chance.
They don't need rackets.
Without it, there's no way.
No.
Bron's got it.
They're so strong. No way.
You're going the Williams sisters.
Yeah.
You would. Girls. Woman power.
That's girl power.
Girl power. Going with.
Okay, so talking about girls, how about some like SNL fighting, like a Molly Shannon and Sherry O'Terry versus okay. like a Tina Fey, Amy Poehler situation?
Okay.
Another fatal four-way.
Yes.
I think this could be a great one, but I already have my pick.
I don't think this is going to be a great one at all. I think it's a great idea. A great idea. Don't get me bashing the idea because I love it. I'm excited to talk
who
about it.
Who do you think has this?
I don't even think it's close. I think it's what? Molly Shannon and Sherry O'Terry.
That's definitely who I was thinking.
I mean, okay. So we got three small women here in a Molly Shannon. Sherry O'Terry is the same.
Small women.
Sherry O'Terry is the same size as a Tina Fey or Amy Poehler, except she has twice the energy. She was that 90s
so much
physical
energy.
Comedy.
Yes.
And Molly Shannon is that even bigger.
And taller.
And even more physical energy, comedy.
Yes.
She took over the physical comedy roles for Chris
Superstar
Farley.
Superstar Molly Shannon.
Breaking tables and all of that on, yes.
Yeah.
Superstar Molly Shannon.
Yeah.
Tina Fey and Amy Poehler, you think like, I don't know if they have enough fight in them. Again, when you mention the energy, Molly Shannon and Sherry Terry's energy would kill it. Like,
okay, I'm thinking of like the little choreographed dance that they did at the end of Sisters.
Yes. Okay. Yeah.
And just, you know.
Weak sauce.
Mm-hmm, compared to like Molly Shannon and Sherry O'Terry flying all over the place.
It'd be messy. Molly and Sherry be so messy.
When I think of those two fighting, I think of like the Tasmanian devil.
Yeah.
How you
just
see, like,
it'd be
a blur.
Just a hot mess. But like all of a sudden they won. And you don't even like see Tina and Amy anymore. It's just like.
There was a fight stoppage due to like fingernail to the eyeball. You know, like,
because they were just running around like insane,
way too
so
crazy,
fast.
Way too fast. Yeah, it's not going to be like a clean fight. There's not going to be like a 1-2 punch combo that knocks them out. No, it's going to be like, you know, there was a groin shot and an eyeball poke.
You don't even know who got it from where, like where it came from.
Yeah.
So you see it the way I do.
I think we're together on this one.
Unanimous.
What do you think about Michael Pena versus Robert Pattinson?
Well, that is just delightfully random.
Random combo I've ever heard.
I'm pulling it.
I like it. Because
Batman versus like TV cop.
Do you know what my first thought is when you said that?
Pattinson's younger.
Is that Michael Pena would make a better Batman than Robert Pattinson would?
Oh, I 100% agree.
I can't disagree. I'm thinking about it. I'm like, yeah, that sounds right.
I would love to see Michael Pena as Batman. I think he has
he's too funny now.
To him.
Yeah. He's too funny
now. He could do grit if he wanted to.
He's such a good actor.
I don't know how I feel. And I think I might have Pena just because of the same Batman decisions that we're saying why I'd still want to see. I want to see Michael Pena win this fight and Batman.
Now, Pattinson's probably gotten in shape for the role. I bet he's gotten in shape for the role.
He's just a chin.
Yeah.
It's so true.
He's all chin.
Face. He'd be so upset after getting hit. Just hit him in the face once.
Yeah.
And he'd be like so upset about it that he's like, I'm done.
Step into the ring haircut. Yeah. All right. I got one more for you. I feel good about this. And then my mind is toast on the matchups. But when we got in... Remember that time when we got into that whole Mexican standoff situation with Charlize Theron and Angelina Jolie?
Uma Thurman.
And
you remember that?
Yeah.
You remember that?
But
I'm thinking about like the Sandler trio, the women that always show up in all the Adam Sandler movies. Jennifer Aniston, Drew Barrymore, and Selma Hayek.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Oh, those three?
The Sandler trio. Like Mexican standoff.
Selma Hayek.
But Drew Barrymore was in Charlie's Angel.
No, soft.
Soft.
She's the weakest link.
She's daytime TV now. She is soft.
She's the old sweet and soft.
As a marshmallow.
Jennifer Aniston's got some fight.
You do not make fun of Drew Barrymore.
I love Drew Barrymore. Celebrity Deathmatch? No.
And Jennifer Aniston.
You think she's going to beat Selma Hayek?
You've seen all the pictures online with Jennifer Aniston turning 51 in the hot body, which she shows off in every... it's like a part of her contract.
Get it.
She has to get naked in any movie you put her in.
You don't eat
anymore.
Doesn't
need to, but she's
Selma.
It's Selma.
It's Selma.
It's Selma.
Well,
I think Jennifer Aniston could put a, could maybe put up a fight for
last longer than Drew.
I think she'd last longer than Drew.
Even if I think you guys are sleeping on Drew. She's got the size Selma Hayek could fit in your pocket.
When even you real, if when either you one of those how won, short
the Selma power Hayek is. Fight behind Selma. No. All right. I'm trying to think of another good one here.
Finish strong, B.
All right. I want to think like out of the box. What about just like a Chrissy Teigen and like Adam Devine? I don't know why my brain went there.
It's also delightfully random.
Very random. It's got to be random because that's what makes it like how
Chrissy Teigen versus Adam Devine and then John Legend to the winner.
Husband-wife matchup?
Yeah.
You think Chrissy could beat John Legend?
I think Chrissy could beat Adam Devine, but then John Legend would get pissed and fight Adam.
And kick the crap out of him.
And kick the crap out of him. Okay. So either way, it's like the Teigen Legend family.
I could actually subscribe to that. Do you,
you don't think Adam would even put a fight against Teigen?
Oh, absolutely not.
No way.
No?
No.
No.
No. As a matter of fact, I like the husband-wife aspect that came into that. That's really good. That kind of made me think of something.
What
if we did a little father-son action?
Oh, what father-son?
I'm thinking Denzel Washington against John David Washington. Father against son.
Versus son?
Father versus son.
Well, Denzel.
I was about to say John David.
John David is in his prime right now.
Yeah, but Denzel knows what's coming at him. Like, he made that shit.
Tenet.
OG. Think,
yeah, like, you're throwing a right hand. I know it's coming. I'm going to throw a left.
Like, I'm your dad.
So you're saying that he just has Father that. He's always going to have that.
Always. Oh, John David's got it.
Always.
I'm going John David.
What about?
Except for I do see your.
I want to John David there. So bad, but I.
He put up a good fight.
There. It makes sense.
Who do you think would win in a fight between Gary Busey and Jake Busey?
Oh, Jake Busey.
Jake.
Jake Busey.
You think he could take his dad?
Oh yeah, absolutely. That's one. I think Denzel, you're right, could end up, and no, Jake would totally take dad.
Yeah.
Denzel's one of the only like fathers that I see could really be going that way. But I like where you're going with Jake Busey.
How do you feel about a funny one?
Let's do it.
Like Dane Cook against Kevin Hart.
Well, that's a fight. Man. Oh,
that immediately made me think like,
My first thought is Dane Cook, but I'm trying to like, hold on
He's
a second.
Taller,
wait a minute.
Bigger.
Hold on a second. Yeah. Kevin has that,
like a stronger.
Kevin has little man syndrome is what Kevin has.
Yeah.
Which means Kevin works extra hard in the gym to work out. He is very fit.
Yeah, he's very fit.
He's an athlete. Like the guy can dunk almost. He can grab rim.
You're talking about four-time NBA celebrity all-star game MVP Kevin Hart here?
I sure am.
He's going to get slammed by Dane Cook. Slammed by Dane Cook.
Wow.
He's twice his size.
And Dane's got some like built up aggression that he hasn't dealt with yet.
And Dane has got some girth to him these days, if you've seen him.
I feel like Dane would need extra girth to
And he's got Kevin. It. Those are some good fights.
Great fights. Interesting.
I'd pay to see half of those, at least.
I gotta say, it's pretty creative stuff. Blair, how's your Chumbawamba challenge treating you? I see that you were just moved on to the last leg of your.
Oh,
you got like a little
four here,
little rosé look on your face.
Yeah.
Right
do
now.
I?
Yes, a little pink in the cheeks.
That cider drink can't be any good.
It
looks terrible.
Is a little tough to get down, but it's going.
You look like you're in a good place.
I'm actually in a great place right now.
So glad to have you back.
I'm gonna just hate this later. I'm going to regret this so much.
You're saying tomorrow could be a different story.
I kind of jumped right back into drinking again. Like, I don't know if many people go straight to Chumbawamba.
You went straight to the deep end on that one.
I did.
And
that was not good.
And you typically stick to like a little neck of beer to half a beer on like when you're getting crazy.
She's in the kids' pool, like knee deep.
So to see you drinking tonight.
I'm drinking.
Drinking. I'm sorry. Gary Busey and Nick Nolte is a fucking awesome fight.
I didn't know they were separate people until I was like 17.
That's a great fight.
That's hilarious.
Well done, you guys. And we did not intend for that segment to get so carried away in this being a one segment episode.
And I have like 10 more like ready.
We'll
to
have
go.
To just come back to this and make it a shorter thing. We got a little carried away tonight. We didn't intend for this to just be the whole segment.
So out of hand.
But fortunately for you, we are starting our first song of the week.
Song of the week.
Ooh, a little musical
Crunchies. Song of the week.
That's
now we
cool.
got.
Yes, I am so excited for this. We love music, love original new music.
Yes, we got a couple hundred submissions in on just this first round.
Yes,
and there was a lot of good ones.
Yes,
and we will be playing one every week, and we will be doing genre hopping all over the place. We may be going heavy one week and hood the next week, and that's us. And yeah. that's what we are going to be doing in this first one tonight. It's just extra crunchy. I want to describe it as like a southern party rock with a mix of that West Coast 90s funk rock, especially the drums that I just love so much. Most of you are thinking Red Hot Chili Peppers right away. It's more Infectious Grooves,
Fishbone,
Super Groove, that kind of thing. Tonight's first song of the week is coming out of Memphis, Tennessee. This is Fever Tree with Led to Believe. Got me amped up.
I'm jamming over here.
I'm not gonna lie.
Air guitar.
That checked a lot of boxes for me.
Yeah.
Bass. You got the infectious drums, strong vocals the whole way through. great shredding with the nice solo in, yes, and then with the bass. We got some elements of Frampton and Bon Jovi. It turned into a little bit.
Some Van Halen riffs.
Yes, there's you can see some of the influences.
Definitely.
As far as the show goes, that hit us directly into the Blake bone.
Yes,
that just
that's got Blake written all over it.
That has got Blake written all over it. But it was a unanimous vote. That was Somethin' Crunchy's Song of the Week. And this has been another episode of Somethin' Crunchy, the first of season 3. Welcome back. It's good to be here.
Yeah, so excited to be back.
Couldn't be happier.
Don't ever forget to live your crunchiest life.
Be crunchy to one another.
Please don't forget to subscribe, like, follow, and all that crunchy good shit. Thank you for listening.
The three-way Mexican standoff?
Mexican standoff is a three-way.
I guess I don't have to say the three-way. Part of that.